What's up, 805? This is Bill Locey right here in Studio 805 for the Ventura County Star. Back from working on my sunburn in Coachella, where I did not buy a shirt. I would have bought a spiritualized shirt, but they didn't have any. Coachella is the greatest music festival within a reasonable driving distance, 210 miles or so south, about 4 hours worth behind the wheel. It was so far away, I listened to the Dodgers lose on three different channels. This was the ninth year of Coachella, and my third. Usual deal, 40-something bands each day, almost all of them are good. On a giant polo field, five stages, lots of walking and sweating, nonstop people watching, band checking out, all that kind of stuff. American Bang from Tennessee was the first band to play, melodic southern rock. It was nice to see Red Cross again. They pretty much invented that whole pop punk thing. The Vampire Weekend had it going on. Architecture in Helsinki became Helstinky, as they were a bunch of clueless doofuses. In addition to all the tunes and the Tim Burton-friendly structures, the weirdest thing was the Do Lab, not to be confused with the Homer Simpson-friendly Dope Lab. It was a bunch of weird giant flowers made out of bamboo, desert tulips maybe, with several shady areas to kick it and a large open grassy area in the middle, parts of which were constantly being sprayed with misters, and there were some skinny streams of water blasting what turned into a giant dance party. Make that a wet t-shirt dance party. And a bunch of old guys drying off to the side were taking pictures constantly. As this place was sort of in the middle of the field, I ended up passing through numerous times. The dancing cast was always different, but the scenario was always the same. I intend on suing more than 750 women for whiplash, and I'll win. Anyway, enough of that, and now this, Rock and Roll Call, the record-rating service of cyberspace designed to cost you or save you several of those hard-earned George Washingtons, depending on whether or not the band stinks. First up, new one by REM, and is appropriately called Accelerate. And it's their best album since the early 80s, or back when they were good. If you were making an REM drive tape, you'd want the first cut on there. Living Well is the best revenge. That's good advice as well. Hollow Man is also a keeper. This one just flat out rocks, or else it has that groovy country rock groove thing, whatever. Also, Until the Day is Done probably has no chance of being heard at the next GOP fundraiser, being all about America circling the drain and all that stuff. Each song is prefaced by a quote by some famous smart guy, and this song cites legendary muckraker Sinclair Lewis, who writes, "When fascism comes to America, it will be wrapped in the flag and carrying the cross." And then I saw REM back in 84, and I bought this cheesy shirt. I saw it with the bowl a few years ago, and I left early. This time around, might buy another shirt. Don't you just hate it when fascism comes to town? They're always so pushy and self-righteous, and they never knock, and they're just so rude. Hate fascists, don't you? I mean, you can't take them anywhere. Next up is a new one from one of my favorites, Jesse Malins. A live one called Mercury Retrograde. It's on Adeline Records. This is a great record. You need it. Trust me this time. Malin is an East Coast, all-in-black singer-songwriter guy who clearly knows what a catchy song sounds like. This is pretty much the same set he played at Zoe's a few months ago, with the same jokes in between. And same in between song banner, he doesn't just do the breakup songs, Since You're in Love is one of the best of those, but he also gets philosophical about the power of music. Broken Radio, Hotel Columbia, Windy, Black-Haired Girl, just one great song after another. Do the math, Malin style. Tragedy plus time equals songs and comedy. Doesn't get much better than this, and all three of his solo albums are also worth having, so there's that. Finally, the latest one from Joan as Policewoman. It's called To Survive, and it's on Reveal Records. And let me reveal this, Joan is Lounge Lizard Crooner is more like it. This sounds like background music at a middle-aged dinner place. Joan Woster, she be the Joan in question, has a nice voice, but the songs are pretty slow-mo and mellow. Too mellow for me, but perhaps not for you. This would be great 2 a.m. hoping to get lucky music. Slayer usually does not work in this scenario, but I myself once mistakenly thought Jimmy Buffett was Slayer, and yes, alcohol was involved, but that's another story for another time. Okay, that's the end of the line for me. I find myself circling the drain once again, and my swimming skills are minimal. This is Bill Locey right here in Studio 805 for the Ventura County Star saying, save the top hat, save yourselves, go check out some live music, have a delightful weekend, go Dodgers. And remember, if no one tells you how to act, then how are you gonna be?